husband decided to run as mayor of Naga, and he won. So, first lady na ako ng Naga. Eh, sa probinsya, yung first lady, maraming obligasyon. So, it became a little difficult already. Because there would be days where I was required to do first lady roles. Okay pa yun. But after a year, we had a baby already. So, I was a new mother. Doon na talaga naging mahirap. Kasi I would be in school 8 to 5 for my teaching work. Then after I go out of this particular school, I transfer to the other school to attend my law classes. Naalala ko noon, 5:30 to 8:30 yung law school. Uuwi ako, alas 9 na. Magpapatulog pa ng anak, matutulog yung anak, almost midnight. Pagtulog na yung anak, saka pa lang ako mag-aaral for the next day. Mahirap na mahirap. There were many times when I wanted to quit already. Hindi ko na talaga kaya. It was the least of my priorities. Ayoko na mag-law school. But my husband wouldn't hear of it. Parati niyang sinasabi, hindi ka pwedeng huminto kasi papatayin ako ng tatay mo. So yung compromise namin, pag nanganganak, kasi when I became a lawyer, I already had two children. Pag nanganganak, leave of absence. Pag election, campaign period, leave of absence because I helped my husband out. Tapos paunti-unti na lang. I wasn't a full-time student anymore. Wala na akong kabatch. Yung mga kabatch ko dati, mga abogado na. Basta akala ko hindi na ako matatapos. Parang my heart wasn't into it anymore. Pero after a few stumbles, naging abogado din. But when I became a lawyer, it became very apparent to me that I wanted public service lawyer.